else we need to talk about? No. Oh, yes, we need to get a name for our team. So our team is usually called Just For Tonight, but we kind of come up with a new name, and that's the name for tonight. So from this side of the audience, what we need is a celebrity you, like, actually admire.
Kristen Bell.
Kristen Bell. I'm taking Kristen Bell because we already did Keanu Reeves at one point. So from this side of the audience, could we get anybody's favorite word?
Fishtail.
I've heard so many things. Nebulous. The Nebulous Bells. Everyone, please welcome to the stage the Nebulous Bells.
The Nebulous Bells. My name is Brad.
I'm Jimmy.
Peter.
Tom.
John.
Melissa.
Rachel.
And we are going to do, to get our improv started, we're gonna talk with one of y'all. So if we could have one brave volunteer come up here, just a short conversation. Nothing pain. There we go.
Whoa!
Hello. What is your name?
My name is Cade.
Cade, and what brings you here tonight?
I was seeing my dad in the level 2 showcase.
Nice. Did he do okay in your
No. Okay. Really, I'm going to have a talk with him when we get back.
You're dead to me!
Everyone's a work in progress. That's all right.
He's had too long.
How about your day?
You know, it was okay. Kind of felt unproductive, but it's like that summertime period
okay.
where like it's reached that point when you're no longer like relaxing anymore
right.
because you want to be doing something,
okay.
but also it's like summer, so you don't want to do anything.
Right.
So it's that like.
So what time did you get up this morning?
I didn't sleep in too much. I got up like a 10, so
okay.
that's not too bad. Yeah, see, this is the state of my life. I didn't sleep in, I got up at 10, it's okay.
What do you do like the rest of the year, like, you know?
I go to RISD. Yeah.
What are you majoring in?
Illustration.
Nice. Okay,
cool.
Great. That's a talent that I do not share.
It's
very bad at drawing.
So
you got up at 10 o'clock, then what did you do?
I went to see my one friend, actually, who just got back from visiting her boyfriend in Puerto Rico. So
now I'm going to point out, you said one friend. Was that your only friend, or were you like a specific friend?
That is not my only friend. I have two friends.
My other friend is my girlfriend who's in Puerto Rico. What'd you guys do?
I just helped her like move into a dorm because she's doing like a summer RA position.
At RISD,
yeah.
Yeah.
I more just like sat there and walked as she moved into a dorm.
Yeah, well,
I retract my statement.
it's important you make sure people lift correctly. I get it. Do you eat today? What'd you eat?
I got like an English muffin from Small Point Cafe. I'm gonna like plug in.
It's delicious.
Yes.
Anything on the English muffin?
Yeah, strawberry jelly. Yeah.
Are you in?
Maybe a little bit. Like
a couple of seeds.
Are
they still in there?
No.
Because strawberry seeds will stay with you.
They do stay.
Yeah. I'm working some stuff out, I'm sorry. Are you an only child?
I am an only child.
Okay, so
it's like the limit.
This isn't a totally you're not a totally brand new person to me then. I know a little bit about you.
Right.
I hear you had a very exciting cameo.
Oh god, why is this every time I'm anybody comes up?
Pretty exciting.
Okay, fine, I'll boast about myself. Yeah, I was a background extra in the recently released Godzilla movie.
What?
Oh!
Why can't we have a Godzilla shirt tonight?
Can you like seen the movie yet?
I have seen that, yeah.
Can you pick yourself out? You're like, oh, that's me.
I couldn't. I definitely know what scene it is.
Right.
I definitely, like, kind of got the vibe, but I was way in the background,
right.
So I'll have to see.
Yeah, still, you know, maybe on 4K Blu-ray.
4K Blu-ray, yeah, exactly.
All right, so you had this English muffin, your friend is moving, and you are supervising. What else, you know?
What else did I do today?
Yeah.
So I like to watch movies. I really like film. But there's also like a lot of weird films that just like I haven't seen
okay.
that I probably could have seen. So this summer, one of the things I am trying to do to be productive, quote
yep.
unquote, is watch movies.
Yep.
I haven't
makes
seen.
Sense.
So yeah, I'm like halfway through Wet Hot American Summer,
oh,
which I've never seen before.
I enjoy it.
Where'd you stop?
Yeah.
What did I saw? Oh God. So many crazy subplots happening at once.
What's Amy Poehler up to?
the camp director just voice the one kid who was like holding a chicken, I can't remember his name, to be in the talent show. And the kid who was like pretending to be a robot and all that.
Oh, okay.
So that around 47 minutes in.
Yes, of course. Your worst part is that's like actually probably where I was at. Like, give or take. this is.
So you watched half of Wet Hot American?
Basically.
Did you have dinner before you came? Or?
I had like a pizza bagel. So.
Lots of round
like
food.
Yeah.
Why is everybody on my back? You know? No. Too much round food. Oh, sorry. Am I becoming round?
Just clarifying.
Okay.
You're good.
I'm sorry.
You're fine. You're in Godzilla. Come
on. I am in Godzilla. There you go.
Was it just one pizza bagel, or is the other pizza bagel in Puerto Rico?
Do we have other questions for Kate while he's here?
I mean, yeah, but I don't want to take up our time.
He's under oath.
So, just between you and the rest of us, like, is Godzilla kind of a jerk?
He was a little pompous, but like, I feel like he had the right to be a jerk. He was okay. Mothra was a bitch, though.
Yeah. Lots of.
I'm sorry.
Mothra is a leader.
Yes.
All
right. We got everything we need. We all good?
Oh yeah.
Yes, let's unpack that. Bumblebees. They're humble, yellow, fuzzy. Nothing to fear.
Oh no, I like the insects. I hate the word.
Oh. Interesting.
It's too alliterative.
Bumblebee. To Bumblebee. I'm a big fan of those robot movies.
I'm having a visceral reaction.
Bumblebee, and you'll have to say, Sensei Hornet. Bumblebee.
Hornet.
Watch your
Hornet.
Filthy mouth.
Just gonna make my own breakfast.
Okay.
And I'm gonna make my breakfast for later.
Yep.
And I'm gonna make one more breakfast. Alright, we're gonna have a good day.
Okay.
Alright?
Whatever you say.
I can't see you, but I can sense your presence.
It's my kitchen, too! I just thought it was... Did you have jelly? I don't have jelly.
Did you go to the jelly store?
I was working. Oh. I was busy. I had to help, like, 3 people move. I'm very busy.
I'm saying that I had to take an extra trip to the jelly store. I thought I had plenty of jelly, but then 2 days ago I didn't have any jelly.
I had the last of your jelly. I should have replaced it.
Do you know what life is like when you only have 2 breakfasts a day?
It's bad. It's real bad.
Real bad.
It's so bad.
I'd venture into brunch territory.
I do not want
any sort of lamb chop or salmon, whatever.
Certainly not. That's practically lunch. Certainly isn't breakfast.
It's the unch part of brunch.
It's the unches. Might as well just have dinner.
Don't you say that word again.
Barry, I could see you. I'm here for your performance review.
Good to see you, Greg. I'm expecting nothing but, good praise.
Well, yes, I would like to give you really great praise. However, you've been coming in rather late on a daily basis, and it's inappropriate for you to be coming in late.
I thought I've been kind of maintaining the schedule for a while. What do you consider late?
Well, I'm very liberal when it comes to, if you're traffic and things like that. If you're 5 minutes, you are 45 minutes late every day. That's late.
How dare you?
What?
How dare you? I'm an illustrator.
See any people.
I'm just an extra.
Go on, son. I'm ready to hear your deepest, darkest secrets.
Dad, I feel comfortable saying this because...
Oh, spread it out there, sonny boy.
Just the 2 of us. I love you and I'm proud of you. Never let anyone know that.
Oh, but wait to hear those words. Since I was a boy. When I was a boy, I was too afraid to tell my father that I loved him. I wish I had some witnesses to this, that my life has finally come full circle and I'm fulfilled, and no one is here. No one can witness it.
I just have to seem cool in front of other people. And I don't love you, and I'm not proud of you. But truthfully, I'm just...
I totally understand, son. See, my father sent me off to the military young, So I never imparted to you that need for sensitivity. You learned that on your own.
But you landed that plane all by yourself on your 10th birthday.
Yes, that's because my father... father really loved skydiving, and he said, take me up, boy. You figure it out. But I didn't do that to you.
Oh, you were there for me.
Always there. Quietly, stoically. When you graduated high school, I didn't bring a sign or anything gaudy. But I stood up.
You clapped twice, and that was enough.
Two claps.
You know, I've never seen The Godfather.
One, two, or three?
Correct.
I never saw Jaws.
One, two, or 3D? I was very privileged as a child. My mother worked at a Blockbuster. My father worked at a Lowe's theater. We saw all the movies as soon as they came out on video. I don't know, but these reviews are due by tomorrow, so I guess we're supposed to watch these movies, talk about them. All I've managed to do is make some paper hats. We got Peter Pan. Captain Hook. I made a boat. It's a good boat. If you rip it, it turns into a t-shirt.
Wow.
A lot of newspaper crafts.
I've been up since 10:45. I am exhausted.
Summer RA. Students aren't at college in the summer. So, who are you advising?
Each other.
It's not about the breadth of experience. The depth of experience. And we went deep.
You know, I can see the bond between the two of you, especially the collective resume that you gave me, and the fact that when I called you,
I picked up.
You picked up, and then when I invited you into the room, you both came in.
Why pay a CEO $20 million? When you can pay two CEOs $10 million each.
See, that's another thing. You play.
So you guys are the new summer advisors.
We were trying to be summer CEOs, but summer advisors it is.
So you give each other advice.
Yeah, but deep advice.
Yeah.
See, it used to be that I was the only summer advisor, and I'd just give myself advice. Now I feel like I'm supposed to give you two advice, and this is really screwing up my whole system. And who's going to give me advice?
Either both.
I mean, that's where we would advise
each other.
All
it's a triangle.
Would give you advice.
I can't a triangle.
That's a process.
There we go. There's a triangle.
Try to stop getting so angry.
Yeah, no. Puerto Rico's awesome. It's so exciting. How are things back there?
Really sad.
Oh.
Hey.
This is my friend Domenico.
Hey.
Oh, hey.
Welcome to Puerto Rico.
It's so
almost
sunny there.
Oh no, the weather's great. Here's trees and birds.
Oh, I heard one. Yeah, it's an Eastern Puerto Rican swallow.
Yeah, the EPRS.
Yeah, it was really weird how you guys just like went and didn't even invite me.
It's it's the study abroad.
Yeah.
We're learning how to draw Puerto Rican style.
Lots of sand.
That's my major.
I mean, it seems like the advisor should have told you.
You're my advisor. My summer advisor.
I sent you.
Man, you're not a very good advisor.
I'm a drawer. That's who I am in my heart. I draw. I illustrate.
It's true.
Look at this sand. Do you think that's real sand? Or
no,
or do
it's
you
a
think,
picture. It's a picture.
No, it's I drew that sand. Each individual.
If you
grain.
Could feel it, it's rough.
Yeah.
It actually has texture.
Yeah, that's a.
It doesn't translate over a phone.
That's an art secret.
Yeah, my screen's all cracked, so it kind of does.
Look.
If I can just say this in Carl's defense, Puerto Rico's really nice.
It's really nice. They don't even card for alcohol here. So I had some Puerto Rican Bud Light.
Yeah, it's like Bud Light.
But Puerto Rico.
We just call it Bud Light here, so.
Isn't that cool?
It is cool. I'm really happy that you guys are having all these new experiences.
Hey, I'm sorry.
Well, not me. I live here.
I'm sorry to go the day before your big move. Did you, my birthday move. Did you find anyone to help you or celebrate with you?
No.
Oh, boy.
Not one. You guys are it. We could just FaceTime the whole 24 hours.
Okay. Truth be told, my wrist is already locking up.
I'm gonna hold up for you. Hey, I'm holding the phone now.
I can tell.
But it's still Carl.
It's me and Domenico.
Yes.
Do you want us to sing you the Puerto Rican happy birthday song?
Absolutely, yes. Immediately. Tastefully
good.
And respectfully.
It's Puerto Rico, that's the only way we do things.
Yeah.
What are you insinuating? I don't like your friend.
His girlfriend.
Oh. I'll just be able to hear that.
You really said Domenico. He's my host, and my teacher, and my advisor.
No, I'm sorry. Just a little jealous. You look so tan already.
It's been a heck of a 6 hours. Most of it's about drawing that sand. Look, anyone at all. You don't have to like him or anything. What about the one that you, that thinks it's a friend? But isn't really a friend.
Oh.
I thought that was a playful thing. It's not. He's still really mad.
Yeah, I can feel it. I can feel the energy. The negative. The eyes. It's all in the eyes. He's got very...
Listen, Gavin, I'm just trying to have a good time here in Puerto Rico. Just, I'm sorry I didn't invite you. Just,
yeah, it's cool. I always wanted to go to Puerto Rico, you know?
Yeah, I know. I would have told you, like, if this wasn't, like, a spur-of-the-moment thing. I just grabbed my backpack and I just went to Puerto Rico.
Eric, why do you have to be such a Mothra? God damn it.
I'm sorry.
Is that your friend?
Yes, this is Domenico. Listen, I
so tan.
Yeah, of course he is.
How about here?
Oh, God, yeah, that makes sense.
No, I'm just saying, like...
Oh, you're FaceTiming too.
Who are you?
Oh, hey.
Still here. Okay? I'm still here.
No, you're just an extra roommate now.
And extra roommates don't say anything. They just blend into the background. I am now a co-roommate.
He's on the poster. Meaning the mailbox.
Yeah.
You made this decision without me. All of a sudden, I'm an extra. It's... This, we rented this together, okay? All of a sudden, I'm an extra.
You used the last of the jelly, Pete.
Could have gotten more jelly.
I had to buy my own jelly, Pete.
Yeah, I mean, I could have gone to the jelly store, too, and bought jelly. I'm
sorry. But you didn't, Pete! You're an extra now!
Okay. Peas and carrots.
Could have been somebody, too.
This is awkward, and you're making it awkward every year. This is a family reunion. You're an extra.
Oh, come on!
What? Your father and I decided we're done with children.
Mama, I'm 27 years old.
Who are you talking to?
I'm here! I know you can hear me, Dad!
Have a shrimp.
No! No! This is horrible! This is very traumatic!
Something so important.
What are you pretending? You can hear me, right? You can...
Yeah, Tony, you're right. Circle pizza in a square box is a metaphor for life.
That's right. That's what my mother always told me.
Gotta make it a square.
Life is like a pizza box with a circular pizza inside of it. Did you know I was in Vietnam? Well, I had another one, but he was in Korea.
Oh.
ran really far one time.
Oh.
Yeah, it's crazy.
So how was your visit with your completely respectful Italian friend?
Kind of offensive. Well, not directly, but I could get kind of a mocking sense in their voice.
So sorry.
It's okay. It's like my mother always said. Life is like a box of pizza with a circular pizza inside of it. And then she died.
So you never heard the end.
I don't know where she was going with it. But it sounded good. That's me in the movie. I'm the one playing Italian Forrest Gump.
Good thing we got the 4K Super TV.
Oh, no.
I wouldn't have even noticed you. You're not even wearing your own clothes. Whose clothes are you wearing? Disgusting.
We didn't pick that out for you.
We paid for you to go to a real college. And this is what you're doing with your life? Running around? Eating pizzas?
Making no sense?
It wasn't a real pizza, it was a fake pizza.
Oh my god. We're Italian.
Just thought we could talk out our differences, Godzilla. I don't see why we have to destroy all these things.
Sorry, get a little angry. It happens.
No, it happens is what you say when you don't want to put the work in. Have you missed? I know that you missed your therapy appointment last week.
Oh, get off my back, Mothra.
Did you call me? Don't say something you can't take back. Okay, GZ? Peaceful resolution of conflict.
I am trying to peacefully let sorry!
Hey, fellas, Godzilla, Mothra, I'm hoping that your conflict will be resolved soon because you're actually laying waste to the entire planet, okay?
Look, we're just talking, okay? How much waste can that make?
I mean, the dead bodies are piling up by the thousands. I mean, come on.
And somehow that's my fault?
Okay. Right. We talk about lying down. We talk about infant
no!
Just lay down like an infant. And just curl up in the fetal position and then stretch out as far as you can.
The last time I laid down, I crushed Detroit.
Yeah.